Indeed, only 31.7% of the job seekers did accept the option for the intensive public counseling. And the experiment, there was also a control group of 4,565 job seekers who only got the standard counseling. They didn't have any option to pick the intensive counseling. And we are interested in how the treatment, so intensive public job counseling, affects a job seeker's probability to find a job. More precisely, the main dependent variable that Behaghel and his co-authors studied is called Job6M, and it describes whether within 6 months after basically the counseling started, a job seeker was no longer registered as unemployment because he found a job. And actually, that is also not so easy to determine whether they have found a job. So if you look at the original article, the official unemployment statistics only record whether they are no longer registered unemployed, but it could also be that they just gave up finding any job. So they did some follow-up phone interviews really to determine those who dropped out as being registered unemployment really found a job. And so whether indeed a job was found after 6 months or not could only be determined for roughly 90% of the subjects. And our subsequent analysis will only be restricted to that subsample where we know whether after 6 months a job was found or not. Let treat option I be a dummy variable that is one if job seeker I was given the option of the intensive counseling treatment. So basically, if he was in the treatment group, and it's zero if he was in the control group, he didn't have the option. And let treated I be a dummy variable that is one if job seeker I indeed got the intensive counseling. So he had the option and he accepted the option. And otherwise is zero. So also kind of like in the treatment group of the people who had the option for intensive counseling, this treated dummy variable will also be zero. And basically for all subjects in the control group, this treated variable is also zero because they did not even have the option for the intensive counseling. Here you see two OLS regressions with a dependent variable whether a job was found within 6 months. And in the first regression, I just regress this job 6N on this dummy variable treat option. And we find a coefficient of 0.032. And this coefficient estimates the so-called intention to treat effect. So the interpretation is as follows. Giving job seekers the option for intensive counseling increases the average probability to find a job within 6 months by 3.2 percentage points. However, recall that only 31.7% of job seekers with a treatment option indeed accepted the treatment. Yeah, so roughly almost 70% didn't really get this intensive job counseling. So if we are interested in the effect of the intensive job counseling, this intention to treat effect probably underestimates the actual effect of the counseling itself, or the effect of the counseling on those who got the counseling. The second regression is here. There I just regressed the dependent variable, whether a job was found within 6 months, on the dummy whether the job seeker was actually treated, whether he actually received the intensive job counseling. And here we find a substantially larger coefficient. Now, the question is now, is this likely an unbiased, consistent estimator of the causal effect of getting the intensive job counseling on the probability to find a job within 6 months? First, make a guess in the quiz.